Hi, it's Darren from Martin Deerline again. Today I'm going to talk about our rotor drive. Checking your Sheave gap, making sure there's grease in the rotor. It's the heart of the combine. If your rotor drive isn't up to snuff, it's pretty hard to get things set right. Your cylinder speed is going up and down and everything. You're not getting all the power and drive to your separator. It's very hard to get your speed set right to thrash property because it's fluctuating all the time. So what we're going to do, the first thing we do is when you're going to check what we call checking Sheave gap, you're going to go into the combine, you're going to start the combine up and engage the separator. After you engage the separator, you're going to push the rabbit turtle for the rotor speed down and slow it down to its slowest position, as slow as it can go. At that point, we're going to shut the combine off, put the key in our pocket, and we're going to come around to the back here. Okay, so now we're at the back of the combine and we're getting up here, up into our rotor drives. So we're going to come up on top. We're going to open up the inspection door here. And we're going to crawl down here. What we're going to want when we go down there is we're going to want a 1/4 inch, a 5/16 and a 3/8 inch drill bit for checking our gap. We'll also want a 15/16 socket and snipe, or 24 millimeter, same size, and a 30 inch wrench as well for adjusting the bar as we're adjusting the belt tension. Okay, so this is your rotor drive gearbox right here. There's four bolts, one, two, and two more on the back side that hold it tight to the frame. It is sitting eccentric in relation to the rotor, so as you roll this back or forth, of course, you increase or decrease this belt tension. There's a big turnbuckle here that you turn to pull it. What you're doing when you're doing this is you're pulling the belt, you've got the machine down at slow speed, you're pulling the belt farther away from the driver. So in other words, you're spreading the sheave as the adjusting the belt tension. So what happens is when we're putting our drill bit in between the sheave and the center, we're measuring how far we're spreading that pulley apart to get the tension correct. We use three different bits as a go or no go gauge. If you come up here to check this, and a 1/4 inch drill bit will not go in there, it needs to be adjusted. So what you want to do is you want to adjust it up so that a 5/16 drill bit will fit in there. That's the goal part. That's where you want the middle of the sweet spot. As you're doing this tension adjustment, you want to make sure that a 3/8 bit will not fit in there. If a 3/8 bit, that is too far open for this. So what happens is if you run this thing up into full speed, you're using maximum rotor speed, and the torque sense wants to tighten up the belt, it can't because it doesn't have any travel left. So now something's got to give, whether you bend the shaft, whether you bugger up a bearing, or most likely blow the belt in half. And that's what will happen. With us, a lot of times when we're combining in our wheat, for instance, we're running with that rotor at max. If you have this sheave gap set too tight, you will bugger up your belt. If your belt is not set tight enough in the sheave gap range, in the lower speeds, you will slip the belt because what happens is you're not in the travel of the cams. So that's how that happens. So it's a very critical adjustment, more important than a lot of guys realize. After you've set that sheave gap and you've got it set to your 5/16, you want to run the rotor up to high speed and shut the combine off. You can come into the in here, and on the back side of the of your rotor drive, if you take this plug out, you can fill that thing with grease. It uses cornhead grease. It does hold 5 tubes of grease. If it's empty, what you want to do is you want to come up here and grease that till you have grease about a 1/2 inch below the plug hole, and then you have grease in your rotor drive. I don't know where that grease goes, but it does disappear. It seems if you don't do this every couple of years at least, you're gonna have issues. Sheave gap you have to check more often than that. Sheave gap you should be checking a couple times a year anyhow. What's happening with that sheave gap, of course, it's belt wear side to side and belt stretch. You're looking after both of those issues when you adjust that sheave gap, and then your rotor drive is good. If you have your rotor drive set correctly on one of these combines, when you plug this thing, the next thing you're doing is turning the key to start it, because it will kill it most dead.